show you is this lovely little mum bath bomb here. So this is a cute little bath bomb. This is one of our smallest ones out of the range. It's £2.95. If you pass it around, have a whiff. Take a photo or not. Feel free to get the right background. Don't get me in it. So this one has Sicilian lemon oil in there, organic sweet orange oil, and balancing and restorative rose oil from Turkey. So this is quite a chilling out one. It smells pretty lovely. I get the rose through there quite a lot, but a lot of people can't smell the rose. They smell a bit more sensitive. I haven't yet seen this one in water either, so I don't know if it's a fast or a slow freezer or not. But we will soon find out. What's it called? It's just called the Mum Bath Bomb. So we've actually got one as well for Father's Day. So we had one for Father's Day last year, but we didn't have one for Mum. And I think people were like, oh, we should have one for Mum. So this is why we did that one. Mood boosting ingredient, which I personally love the idea of as well. So this one has, it's also toning as well again. It's got grapefruit oil in there as well from Sicily, and that's really refreshing. It's got the rosewood in there, which is antiseptic too. And it's also got the orange flower absolute, which is really, really uplifting. So it's really gorgeous. All round kind of like happy bubble wine. Mm-hmm. But this is still going, see Daisy? What do you think of that one? Some people either love neroli or they kind of don't
like it.
Yeah, some people just can't get enough of it. They love it so much. Your mother should know. Your mother should know.
Oh yeah.
But
if I said the baby stuff.
I hadn't thought about that, but yeah, I guess that makes sense. So let's break a bit off here, see how it's going to go. It's really like bright for us to see. Ham again. Really for her.
I'm gonna make you mine.
natural skin oil. Closest oil to a natural skin oil. It's actually got honey in there and vegan white chocolate. It's not vegan, unfortunately, because of the honey in there, but it is smell amazing. It smells amazing. I'm literally, I love it. I think it's so good. Yeah, I think that's good.
That didn't work,
Great for any sensitive skin, reducing any redness and balancing oil levels as well. So before we start making it, I'd like everyone to sort of have a feel of it on the skin. So I'm going to take up a nice big chunk and come around and rub your hands with it. We'll start off with the water. Can you put that in the bowl for me? Yeah, if you want to, as long as all the water's in there, I don't mind. Right, fabulous, so send it down. And now we're going to mix in the fragrance here. So in the fragrance, that'll have the French lavender in there, the rose absolute.
I haven't seen how much of everything. Is this all measured out very carefully?
Yes, it is indeed. And then we've got glycerin. Has anyone ever heard of glycerin before?
I also put that in my...
Glycerin is actually a byproduct of making soap. I should mention that here at Lush, we don't use any palm oil in any of our soaps whatsoever. It's all a coconut oil and rapeseed oil base because we don't want to contribute to any deforestation, and we like everything that we use to be totally traceable. So glycerin is a great binding product, but also is a carrier, which means it carries ingredients further into the skin, so you get more nutrients from it. So, Jaleen, if you'd like to pour that in, all of it please. So I should also mention the fact that we use our glycerin is really important because it shows our commitment to reducing waste and using everything that we make. Right, that's grand, thank you very much, so send it down. So if you'd like to mix that up.
It feels really good.
It already smells good. And I don't know, what is it?
Right, okay, so when that's nicely mixed, our next ingredient is going to be kaolin. So this is a mineral clay, very absorbent, so great for sort of cleansing the skin. Also nice and mattifying as well, and it's going to be really good for getting rid of any residue. So, let's send that down. Louise, if you want to pop all of that in for me?
All of that?
Yes,
please. Sure.
Yeah,
absolutely everywhere.
So, I don't know if Ron, we mentioned earlier on that we've got a self-preserving campaign on at the moment. It's a movement to sort of use as little preservatives as possible. Kaolin is actually a natural preservative where it's so drying, so that's why this is going to need a preservative. So, would you like to mix that for me, Scott?
Yeah, why not?
There you go.
Go for it. And baking skills going hand, and I do not bake.
Yeah,
I don't bake.
Now you do.
Yeah, I do. I bake enough for that. So. What is it you've got for like the liquid that's in it? Oh, definitely going. I like myself. Just all between my fingers.
Pull it off your fingers.
Yeah, if you could, that would be great. Right.
Brilliant.
Cool.
There we are. So, now we're going to go over here. She's pulled the ground almonds. Now, I don't know if you got a chance to catch a little bit of that video, but all of our almonds come from Mallorca in Spain. There we are. You like to throw that in
for
me?
How much?
The whole thing.
I've only got one glove.
I need one.
You shouldn't have taken your glove off, should you? I feel like I'm making a cake.
So, I should also say, again, we head waste here at Lush. So when we harvest our almonds, that's our ground almonds, we use our almond shells as a scrub. Anything we don't use actually gets thrown into a machine which creates biofuel, which powers the machine that harvests the almonds. So, nothing goes to waste here. Right, how are we getting on? If you want to send it down to our exfoliant as well. And as I mentioned earlier, lavender is great for balancing sebum levels. So I'm going to chuck that in the middle. And then I'm going to try and squeeze it in. This is where I'm going to try and roll. So as we mentioned, bakers, I'm sure you've been brilliant at this. Me, not so much, but I'll try my best. So try and roll it up. Rightio, so there we are. There is our fresh facial cleanser. So I'm going to chop it up into bits for you. You can put them in your pot and then we can get some labels on them. And as I mentioned, I'm going to get you to join the party with yourselves because you made these and you deserve to have your face on them.